this life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. M&M's, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top, pop it, let it bang. For this life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. M&M's, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top, pop it, let it bang.
Drop it, pop it.
Drop the top, play hide and seek. Jump inside, jump straight to the lead. Take a sip, feel just how I be. On freeway, but no, ain't nothing free. Been lost, been lanes. Been busting bills, but still ain't nothing changed. You in the mob, soon as you rock the chain. She caught the waves, just thumbing through my brains.
Heat them, belly, I just heat them.
All right, hi, I'm Rick Rams, Dean of Kinesiology and Athletics. Today I'm joined with Margaret Mohr, women's basketball coach. Coach, thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me.
All right, we're coming off your second consecutive Orange Empire Conference Championship. We're returning only four sophomores, and we have a very, very young group.
Yes.
Talk a little bit about where we're headed this season as you look to win your third straight Orange Empire Conference Championship.
Wouldn't that be an awesome accomplishment? You know, and I wouldn't put it past this team if we work really hard and we stay together. I think the challenge this year, obviously, is growing all the time. Our preseason, by design, we put ourselves in really tough tournaments. We schedule really tough non-conference opponents. And this year's no different. And right now, where we're at is not where we want to be, but it's all a process of getting better, of being challenged. And I think they're learning what it takes to be a college athlete, to be a college player. I think the sophomores, you know, just a year removed from their freshman year, are really stepping up, really getting out of their comfort zone and being leaders, vocal leaders. So I'm really excited.
Absolutely. This year, your team has a bit more size than you've typically had in the past. And also, perhaps you haven't been without that go-to score nonstop and consistently. Mm-hmm. Last couple of years, you've had someone who could maybe come in earlier in the season and be in that role. This year, we're spreading the ball around. Gabby's averaging 14 points a game. You're still getting consistent play, but what do you look at in terms of having to develop that go-to person?
Yeah, we're really different, and I think obviously at our level, most of the good post players are snatched up, and I think this was one of our best recruiting classes in terms of what was out there, and two of the premier posts that we brought in were Hannah and Krista, and so I really think they're going through a learning curve right now, but they're very productive in terms of their activity level. Finding that go-to person, we're going to be different because of our size and because of what I think will be our advantages against some of the other teams we play. But I think Gabby is definitely going to be a go-to person. And I think Monet is a person that can take, you know, anybody off the dribble. Vivian Lara, you know, she's not at full strength yet, but when she, you know, gets at full strength, she's very much a scorer. So I think in those people we'll find that go-to player. But I think all of our teams tend to be very well balanced. You cannot key on any person. And I think this team, once we find our style, once we find our niche, once these freshmen realize what they can do at this level, I think, again, we'll be a well-balanced team with a lot of people to reckon with.
And you've highlighted a couple individuals, including your sophomore captain. Talk about some of the freshmen that you have very high expectations for this year.
Well, I mentioned Hannah and Krista. Right. You know, both of them were very sought-after recruited players. Both of them probably could have played at some smaller four-year schools, mm-hmm. and we're really glad that they came here. And I shared with them that they came here knowing the other person was coming here. Mm-hmm. So I like that they didn't avoid competition. Additionally, I think Taylor Nance from Edison, really good shooter. She had a slight injury. We're kind of going through an injury bug, you know, that is really affecting us. Somebody I think that was overlooked was Teresa from Cerritos. Teresa's just a Taurus, just a little mighty mite, kind of like the similar style that we've had in the past. And I think she's going to do some really good things. Devin Barner has been injured right now, and I'd love to see her get back on the floor. I think she has a lot to offer. And then Ty Hudson and Natalie Cruz, you know, being some bigs off the bench that provide a lot of, you know, size inside and take up some space that really makes us, you know, kind of dominant on the boards if we play like I think we can.
Awesome. Well, we get our women's Lady Charger Classic started this weekend here in Don Johnson Court at Gym 2, Cypress College. So for all the folks who are watching this interview, hopefully they'll come out and support our ladies Chargers basketball team, culminating potentially in a championship game this Sunday at 3 o'clock.
We appreciate all the community support and our fans and our families. And we're going to play our best for everybody out there. And I think you're going to see some great basketball this weekend and some great basketball the rest of the season.
All right. Well, we hope to be sitting back here as we're getting gearing up for a postseason. So we'll be following you all season long. And, Coach, thanks for joining me.
Thanks, Rick. All right. Love your support.
I'm now joined with sophomore Gabby Carbajal. Gabby, thanks for joining me.
Thanks.
Gabby, you're a team captain this year, and you're taking over a team that has won back-to-back Orange Empire Conference championships. Yeah. As you're getting ready for this year's Orange Empire Conference season, what are your expectations?
Personally, I have high expectations individually and for the team as well. And we made really high goals, and I think we can get a three-peat this year. So, yeah.
What do you tell a lot of the girls coming into this program of what a season will be like with Coach Mohr, and also the expectations of being successful, given 100%, being competitive, being tough mentally, physically? How do you convey that message?
I would say I learned a lot from the sophomores last year. They're really great leaders, and all their advice, like, I took it to heart, and I try to show it to the freshmen coming in, and I tell them it's going to be a long season, but if we stay together, if we stay united throughout the whole season, like, we'll be strong.
You're a kinesiology major, possibly an aspiring coach one day. Yeah. What are some of the characteristics that you think you value the most out of Coach Mohr?
I value her honesty, her trust, her passion, and her toughness.
Well, Gabby, we look forward to following the Lady Chargers this year. Good luck this coming weekend, and keep up the great season you're having thus far.
Thanks.
Good job. I'm now joined with sophomore Monet Ward. Monet.
Hi.
Thanks for joining me.
Nice to be here.
Talk a little bit about the mindset of the girls as we're getting ready to get into a very challenging tournament and open with Santa Barbara here this weekend.
I think our mindset that we have this weekend is to just have a comeback from the past tournaments that we've been having, to just go all out for this tournament, and just to remember that if we just have the effort and the work ethic that we have as a team and play as a team, then we'll do well in this tournament.
If you had a word of advice to the freshmen coming in, a lot of these girls who haven't maybe competed at this level or played for a coach that's as intense as Coach Mohr, and also with the staff that, I mean, with Coach Amaku, Coach Ford, I mean, you really have a pretty good, you know, program that you're running under. What's a word of advice you'd give to a lot of the freshmen?
I would say effort. That's one of the biggest things Coach Mohr would want us to put in into this program, is effort, and just trust the process of building our relationship on the court and off the court, because to be able to be a team, we have to have that chemistry on the court and off the court as well.
One of the things that you've observed is having a sister who also played for this program, and I commented to you before the season even began, this is a unique opportunity to have a sister who wins a couple titles, and you have a chance to be a part of a couple titles too. What would it mean to you to see this group improve to the point where you have a chance to essentially help Coach Mohr clinch her third consecutive conference title?
I think it would mean a lot to me, because personally, becoming like a sophomore, just learning from my freshman year that of how the team was last year, of how much work we put in, I just think that if we put as much work as we did last year, then we'll be good.
For this life I cannot change. In the hills, deep off in the main. M&M's, sweet like candy cane. Drop the top, pop it, let it bang.